Hello students, welcome to the fourth video lecture in the course Operating System. Myself Rafiqul Islam, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Guru Nanak Institute of Technology under GIS Group. In third video lecture, we have covered different hardware protection in operating system and system calls and different types of system calls. Now, in this lecture, we have to study a very important topic, that is structures of operating system. So in this chapter, in this part, we have to study structures of operating system. So basically, in this lecture, we will be discussing about structures of operating systems. So here we are going to discuss the actual structure of operating system, not the types of operating system. Please verify it. This is not the types of operating system. Actually, types of operating system, which we have already discussed in one of the previous lecture. We know that OS is a large and complex system. OS is a large and complex system, and it has to be engineered carefully so that it works properly and it can be modified easily. So there are different structures that have been followed from the beginning till now, using which the operating system have been designed. So we will be discussing about some of the structures, and we will see the advantages and disadvantages of those structures. So in this part, basically we are going to discuss about five different structures. So the first one, this is called simple structure. Number two, which is called monolithic structure. Number three, this is layered structure. Number four, this is called microkernel. And number five, this is called modules. So these are five structures which we have to study in this section one by one. So now see the first structure, that is simple. So this is the simple structure. So actually first of all, let us go to the first structure that was followed in designing OS, which was used in the very beginning, called simple structure. So in this structure, there are four parts basically. This is ROM BIOS, device drivers. The second one is device drivers. This is resident system programs, and this is application programs. So the simple structure was followed for most of the OS that were designed from the very beginning. And this simple structure OS did not have very well defined structure. So in this diagram, in the figure, it is showing a simple structure. It is actually followed by MS-DOS, Microsoft Disk Operating System. So here in bottom, we have ROM BIOS device drivers, and it is, so we think of this as your base hardware. So we can call it base hardware. And then top of this layer, we have the device drivers. Then we have the resident system programs, and at topmost level, we have application programs. And in this diagram, it is clear that the device drivers, they have access to this ROM BIOS device drivers. And we see that resident system programs, they have access to the device drivers as well as ROM BIOS device drivers. And then even the application program, they have access to the resident system programs and as well as ROM BIOS device drivers. So we see that the base hardware or ROM BIOS device drivers can be accessed by all the things above it. So here the base hardware is accessible by all the other layers. Okay. So we see that this structure, the interfaces and levels of functionality are not well separated. So even though it looks like a layered structure, but it is not actually a layered structure, because all these layers have access to the hardware. So here it may so happen that if any user program fails, then the entire system will be crashed. So it is not well protected, not well structured, not well defined. So this structure is not efficient. Okay, so it is not a very good structure. Actually, in this time, there were no dual mode or hardware protection. Okay, so this is all about simple structure. Now, go to the next, that is monolithic structure. So, in case of monolithic structure, this was followed by the earlier Unix operating system. And this is also a simple like structure and limited structure. Actually, monolithic means so many functions are packed together in a section. Monolithic means so many functions are packed together in a section. So here, everything is packed into one level. Hence, it called as monolithic. So here, basically, all the functionalities are packed into kernel. So now, the problem with this is that there are too many functions packed into one level, and this makes it implementation and maintenance very difficult. So instead of layering, in case of monolithic structure, we have so many functions are packed together in kernel. So to maintain and implementation is very difficult. And also debugging is very difficult here. Okay, so this is all about monolithic structure. Now we have another structure. This is layered structure. So in this particular case, we have layering. Suppose this is hardware. This is another layer. Layer one, this is another layer, and suppose this is the last layer, and this is called layer N, user interface layer. Layer N, user interface layer. Okay. So in layer 0, this is layer 0, we have hardware. So here, in contrast to the monolithic system that we just seen, where everything is packed together in a single layer, but here broken down the functionalities into different layers. Broken down the functionalities into different layers. So it is easy to implement. It is easy to implement and maintenance. because if we have a fault in layer 1, then just we have to solve it into this layer. No interaction between any other layer, right? So it is very easy to maintain. Simplifies debugging and system verification. So here debugging is very simple and also system verification is simple. So here, in order to access the hardware, we have to go all the layers one by one. So it takes more time. So it is actually disadvantage of this structure. And defining the layers is difficult. So here we have some advantages. It is very easy to implement, maintenance, simple debugging, simple verification. But here, in order to access the hardware, it is time consuming. And also, in designing this structure, the defining the layers is very difficult. Okay, so this is layered structure. So now we have another type of structure. This is called microkernel. Microkernel. So now coming to the next one, this is called microkernels. And this is another structuring of OS. So structures the OS by removing all non-essential components from the kernel and implementing as system and user level program. So here we have to remove all non-essential components from kernel. So here the kernel is micro. Micro means small. So here we have smaller kernel. Main function is to provide a communication facility between client programs and the various services that are also running in the user space. And it is easier to extend the OS, and new services are added to the user space and consequently do not require modification of the kernel. Easier to maintain OS code. OS is easier to port one OS to another. And here we have more security and reliability. So here, this is the structure. Here we have hardware. And here we have microkernel. And in this part, we have different user level program, file server, process management server, etc. So this is basically kernel mode. And this is user mode. Actually, kernel mode and user mode, we have already discussed in one of the previous lecture. Okay, so this is microkernel structure. So now we have another and last operating system structure, this is called modules. So another structure, this is called modules. Actually, modules means we follow modular approach in the structuring of OS. And this is the best OS structure using to design OS today. So here, in a particular module, we have core, kernel, and in different part, we have scheduling classes, here we have file systems, here we have loadable system call, suppose here we have another module, here we have another module. So here different functionalities are present in the form of different modules, and which will be loaded to the kernel either at boot time or at runtime. So this is actually modular approach of operating system structure. Okay, so these are five structures. Number one, simple structure. Number two, monolithic structure. Number three, layered structure. Number four, microkernels. And number five, modular approach or modules. Okay, I think this concept is clear to you. Okay, so now here actually we completed our first module, that is module 1. We discussed in syllabus, there are 5 modules in our syllabus, so up to lecture 4, this is module 1. So in our next module, we have process management. And we know that there are 3 parts, basically. Process concept, thread concept, and process scheduling. So in next video lecture, we have to study about process management. So I hope this part is clear to you. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Thank you once again.